Section 4. Who am I? And how dare I say these things? You see, this is not an easy conversation for me. You see, we live in the world now that I helped create. The blood is on these hands. I spent 10 years of my life, from the age of 26 until 36, in serially monogamous lesbian relationships and working to advance LGBT rights. But from the age of 22 until 28, I dated men. And while I was publicly dating men, I was privately falling in love with women. And when I met my first lesbian lover, life finally came together for me and made sense. I came to Christ in 1999. I broke up with my lesbian partner because I was convicted of my sin, but my heart was a mess. I never called any of my lesbian partners my wives or my wife because my queer and postmodernist allegiance convinced me to reject the all things heteronormative, including the language husband and wife that undergirded it. Indeed, when people would say to me, "Don't you want to advance the cause of LGBT marriage?" I would say, "Why add good people to a sick institution?" I and others of my queer generation rejected the idea that we were born this way. We thought that language was pejorative, even pathological. Instead, I believed that my lesbian sexuality was a cleaner and a more moral sexual choice. Conversion to Christ did not initially change my sexual attraction for women. What conversion did change immediately was my heart and my mind. Indeed, I was not converted out of homosexuality. I was converted out of unbelief. My mind was on fire for the Bible, and I could not read enough of it or enough about it. I also developed deep and resonating friendships with both men and women in my church. And through the means of God's grace, I learned to repent of sin in a holistic way. I began to see that my sexual desires for women were not a reflection of who I was, but rather a distortion of it through original sin, a distortion that I had allowed to become an indwelling sin through practice over years and years. One quotation from John Owen really stood out to me during these years. The Puritan John Owen said this, quote, "You cannot mortify a specific lust that is troubling you unless you are seeking to obey the Lord from the heart in all areas." I realized that focusing on one sin to the exclusion of all the others was not what God was calling me to do. And because lesbianism was both my sexuality and my identity, it was very painful to even see it as a sin at first. But I realized through John Owen that Christ bled as much for the sin of my pride and lying as he did for my sexual lust. And soon, union with Christ became a central component to my identity. And it was then that I noticed it. Sexual attraction to anyone or anything forbidden by God is degrading.